Good morning, dear students. This is Lakshmi Krishnan. Today I am going to explain the prose lesson with the title The Black Aeroplane, which is the second part of lesson 3, two stories about flying from the book First Flight. This is written by Frederick Forsyth, an English author. Before you know about the story, let me tell something about Frederick McCarthy Forsyth, the author of this story. He was born on 25th August 1938 in Ashford in Kent in Southeast England. He has been a journalist and then he took to writing novels using the research techniques which he followed in journalism. His first bestseller, The Day of the Jackal, became an international bestseller and gained him the Edgar Allan Poe Award for Best Novel. He is also best known for his thrillers such as The Odessa File, The Fourth Protocol, The Dogs of War, The Devil's Alternative, The Fist of God, Icon, The Veteran, etc. Forsyth's works frequently appear on bestsellers lists, and more than a dozen of his titles have been adapted to film. By 2006, he had sold more than 70 million books in more than 30 languages. The story Black Aeroplane is about a pilot who feels happy and excited to fly over a city that is sleeping. He is flying from Paris to London. While taking his flight, he dreams about the long holiday with his family. He also fantasizes about the scrumptious breakfast he would have upon landing. But soon he has to face a stormy weather. The chapter deals with how he miraculously escapes it and lands safely. At the outset, we find that the narrator is flying by an old Dakota aeroplane, DS-088, from France to London. The time is 1:30 in the morning, and he is flying above the countryside where all the people are fast asleep. The sky is clear and cloudless, and he is able to see the moon and the shining stars. The narrator is quite happy and dreams of reaching home and having a good big English breakfast. You should surely know why the narrator is very excited about the breakfast. A full breakfast is a substantial cooked breakfast often served in UK and Ireland that typically includes bacon, sausages, eggs, black pudding, baked beans, tomatoes and mushrooms, and a beverage such as coffee or tea. It is also called as fry-up. The idea of the English breakfast as a national dish goes right back to the 13th century. In the old Anglo-Saxon tradition of hospitality, households would provide hearty breakfasts for visiting friends, relatives, and neighbors. For the narrator, it is quite an excitement as he is going to be with his family on a holiday. Naturally, having such a scrumptious breakfast is a part of his enjoyment at home. Coming back to the story now. After thinking about what he'll do after reaching home, the narrator calls up to Paris Air Traffic Control. He informs about his landing in England. The person at the other end guides that he ought to turn 12 degrees west now. According to the information given, the narrator turns 12 degrees west towards England. He thinks it's an easy flight and again thinks of reaching home and having a good English breakfast. Then comes a frightening situation. He has 150 kilometers still to fly to reach England. Suddenly, huge storm clouds develop. He is not able to fly above the clouds to escape the storm. This is because he has very less fuel, and so managing to use it carefully becomes an important option. In this alarming situation, he finds that Everything has gone blank due to the stormy weather conditions. Adding to his worry, also the aeroplane jumps and twists. The compass, which shows the direction for flying, and the other instruments do not work. Above all, he is not able to connect through radio signal with the air traffic control in order to get some help. He now finds another aeroplane. Strangely enough, it does not have light on its wings, but the narrator sees that the other plane is flying next to him through the storm. He also sees that the pilot's face is turned towards him. The narrator is glad to see him. The pilot of the other plane waves hand at him, asking him to follow. The narrator's plane follows him like an obedient child. Soon, the narrator feels frightened once again. He thinks about the distance he has to cover. Half an hour later, the strange black aeroplane takes a downward flight. Suddenly, the sky is found to be clear. The narrator is able to see two straight lines of lights in front of him. He understands it is his destination and that he has reached safely. He looks out for the black aeroplane which guided him. He also wants to meet the pilot of that plane to thank him. He inquires the woman in the Paris control center about it. When the narrator asks the woman, she informs there was no other plane except his which flew that night. The narrator is quite surprised and is pushed to some thoughts. The narrator keeps thinking as to who helped him arrive there safely and who the other pilot was whose plane flew alongside his. The author ends the story, thus creating a suspense for the readers. Now, you can think who must have helped the narrator. There are different answers to the narrator's questions from different people. Considering that the black aeroplane and the pilot inside it to be the optimism and hope in the narrator, we can deduce the moral of the story as follows. Man should never lose hope during crisis, but be optimistic and try to help oneself, taking risk and accepting the adversities of life as a challenge.